The Capitol rioter that allegedly stole Nancy Pelosi's laptop has finally been convicted by a jury this week. The woman is an individual named Riley June Williams. She was on surveillance video in the Capitol, on surveillance video encouraging people to physically push back against the police officers. She bragged on social media about stealing Nancy Pelosi's laptop and a hard drive, saying she was trying to sell it to the Russians. And now she has been found guilty of 6 felony counts. Except she was not convicted of stealing government property because they couldn't find the laptop. The laptop that was stolen from Nancy Pelosi's office still hasn't been located. So lacking that physical evidence, the jury was deadlocked on whether or not to convict her, even though she bragged on social media that she had stolen it. She had later told the FBI that no, she didn't steal it. But you said you had. And of course, what you say on social media technically is not legally binding, so the jury was not able to convict her of that. She also has ties to the far-right nationalist Groper movement. She was actually wearing a shirt during the riot, said, "I'm with Groper." She was arrested, by the way, two weeks after the riot. So it's not like they just found her. They got her 2 weeks after the riot, arrested her, charged her, and only just now this week, right before Thanksgiving, finally convicted her. Now, I know it takes time to gather evidence, but we got to work a little faster here, guys. We really, truly do. Because this is clearly an individual that shouldn't be allowed to walk around. Justice should be swift, thorough, but swift. And with a lot of these Capitol rioters, it has been anything but swift. But even though they weren't able to get her on the laptop charge, like I said, they got her for 6 other felonies. So her sentencing date was set for in the future, which is what happens. They don't do the sentencing right then. However, she's not allowed to go free while awaiting her sentencing. Because in a shock move to everybody in that courtroom, the judge ordered Ms. Williams to go directly to jail while she awaits her sentencing, which means she will not be spending Thanksgiving. She did not spend Thanksgiving, I should say, with her family. She's not going to spend Christmas with them. She's not going to enjoy the holiday season and then get her sentencing, a month or two down the road. She went directly to jail, did not pass go, did not collect $200. And she will sit there until she is sentenced, at which point she will likely be transferred to a federal prison, which is probably going to be far worse. But this is what these people deserve, and I have no sympathy for them whatsoever. Hopefully the sentencing is fair. Hopefully it matches up with the 3 felonies she was convicted of. But I have to imagine she's probably going to be sitting in jail for at least another year or two, all because of these stupid decisions following this charlatan Donald Trump that got thousands of people in trouble while that dude's just walking free, shrugging off every investigation on the planet. And I hope these Capitol rioters, while they're rotting away in prison, think about that too. He didn't come to your defense. You came to his. That's why you stormed the Capitol. He hasn't been there for you. He's not paying your legal bills. He's not sticking up for you. You're rotting away, and he's having the time of his life chilling at his golf course.
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.